Hi, and welcome back to Logitech. Today, I wanted to make a quick video to show you how to connect your LIGHTSPEED keyboard to your computer. LIGHTSPEED is our incredibly low latency wireless protocol for keyboards and other time-critical peripherals like mice and headsets. In this video, we're just focusing on getting your keyboard connected. Before we start, go ahead and pause the video and click the link in the description to download G-Hub. Your keyboard will function just fine without it, but it enables you to assign macros, control your RGB, set up gaming profiles, and tons of other stuff. First, let's gather all of the included peripherals. You'll need your keyboard, the LIGHTSPEED dongle, the extender, and the cable. If your keyboard is wireless only, like the G613, you'll have a USB extension cable. Let's go ahead and power up the keyboard and tap the button with the lightning bolt to make sure we're using the LIGHTSPEED connection. Before we get into the larger setup, if you're gaming on the go, there's no issue connecting the LIGHTSPEED dongle directly to your laptop, like so. But for more established setups and for a little more redundancy, we'll want the cable and extender involved for reasons that I'm gonna come back to. Let's go ahead and grab the cable and connect that to a free USB port while leaving the smaller USB connector near where your keyboard will be. From there, go ahead and plug the LIGHTSPEED dongle into the extender if you haven't already, and then connect the other end of the extender to the cable. If your keyboard only came with a USB extension cable, just plug your LIGHTSPEED dongle directly into that. The USB extension is going to serve a few purposes. One, this will close the distance between the dongle and the keyboard, assuring lower latency. On rechargeable keyboards, this will allow you to charge the keyboard when necessary without sacrificing time, so nothing gets between you and the game. And this way, it only takes up a single USB port for both wireless or wired. Lastly, this provides some distance between any Wi-Fi devices in your computer. With that in mind, for the best experience, it's important to make sure your device is at least a couple meters away from any wireless routers or other devices that may emit strong 2.4 gigahertz signals. Now that we've completed the hardware setup, go ahead and run the G-Hub installation you downloaded earlier. And in another video, I'll show you a quick primer of some of the things you can do with G-Hub. If you have further questions or concerns, please visit our support page where you can find FAQs, our knowledge base, and a lot of other cool resources that will help you get the absolute best out of your products. Thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.